Cuando mataron a mi esposo, yo era como a las 12 del día. Llegaron cinco maleantes. Y entonces fue cuando con esa M16 lo mataron a mi esposo. No crea que ha sido fácil para mí. Mi hermano me mandó a traer y porque, pues sí, la situación en El Salvador es tremenda también. Y nosotros venimos a trabajar, no hacerle daño a nadie.
I think every administration has rules, and I can see now, you see? So this administration decide to go against all immigrants.
Maria Fuentes emigrated from El Salvador to the United States about 20 years ago, after gang members from MS-13 killed her husband. And for most of those two decades, Fuentes has worked at the salad bar inside the U.S. Senate cafeteria.
Yo los trato bien, no trato la manera de servirles, pues que estén comiendo en lo limpio, que no pongan complaint.
Fuentes is in the U.S. on a work visa known as TPS, or Temporary Protected Status. But her future in the United States is uncertain. In January, the Trump administration ended TPS for Fuentes and 200,000 other Salvadoran immigrants. Come September 9th, 2019, they face deportation back to El Salvador. But unlike some of those 200,000 potential deportees, Maria works face to face with the very people who could help her stay in the United States.
19 años de pagar impuestos. Ahí tengo toditos los impuestos que los que he pagado. Y los permisos también los que he pagado. Así es que estos son los permisos. Es el permiso que estoy pagando por $600 por el permiso cada 18 meses. Tengo tres hijos. Bueno, yo me vine primero que ellos porque yo como soy madre soltera. Mi esposo lo mataron en el 93. Y entonces me quedé sola. Y eso para mí pues sería un fracaso que yo me iría de vuelta para allá a vivir lo mismo, digamos, a tener aquel terror con mis hijos, que yo ya soy un hombre y ya no quisiera vivir yo, digamos, esa tragedia de que me vayan a matar un hijo, porque ahí quizás, ahí me moriría yo también de la pena.
TPS originated with President George W. Bush when, in 2001, he granted Salvadorans the work visa after a pair of devastating earthquakes hit the Central American country. During the Obama administration, the program was renewed, not just because of the earthquakes, but also because of the country's high poverty level, a recent drought, and increased gang violence. But with the Trump administration, TPS will cease to exist. As it cites, the original conditions caused by the 2001 earthquakes no longer exist.
Bueno, yo este país me lo imaginaba como un paraíso. Cambia las cosas, porque mire, ese señor pues, ha cambiado las leyes y todo es diferente. Pero este señor que está así, siempre a nosotros los ha tratado mal. Porque los otros días oí la noticia que dijo que nosotros éramos unos animales.
But we're taking people out of the country. You wouldn't believe how bad these people are. These aren't people. These are animals. And we're taking them out of the country at a level and at a rate that's never happened before.
Nosotros no somos animales. Y por eso lo sentimos mal. Que lo tratan mal a uno. Y eso no tiene que ser así porque nosotros no venimos a hacerle daño a nadie.
Connie Linares is an activist fighting for the rights of low-wage immigrant laborers who work in federal buildings.
People working 20 years in one of the buildings, and they treat them like they're nobody. You are a human being. You need to stand up and say something. But it's really hard, you know, really hard. What the government is gonna do without these people? There is gonna be 200,000 people that supposedly they're going back to El Salvador. What are these people gonna do over there? There is no jobs over there. Hi. Hi. Hey. Those are my dreamers. And I encourage everybody who has TPS, go out and fight for your rights. Because they have rights. They pay taxes. They pay Medicare. They pay Social Security, federal, state. What is gonna happen with all that money? The IRS, is there all these people's living? They're gonna give it to them? For Social Security? No, I don't think so, you know?
The Trump administration has also canceled TPS for Hondurans, Haitians, and Nicaraguans living in the U.S. But there are also currently four proposed congressional bills aiming to provide a path to permanent residency for TPS holders. As U.S.-based Salvadorans await legislation on the TPS program, Fuentes continues to work on Capitol Hill, serving lunch to those with the political capital to help her and others who would benefit from a TPS extension.
A ver cómo estos 18 meses que los ha dado. A ver si hacen algo los senadores.